हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द सेकंड न्यूमेरिकल ऑफ टू हिंट आर्च। क्वेश्चन इज रिटन एज अ पैराबोलिक आर्च हिंट एट द एंड्स हैज अ स्पान ऑफ 30 मीटर एंड राइज ऑफ 5 मीटर। अ कंसंट्रेटेड लोड ऑफ 12 किलोन्यूटन एक्ट्स एट 10 मीटर फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट हिंज। कैलकुलेट रिएक्शन एट सपोर्ट, बेंडिंग मूवमेंट, रेडियल शेयर एंड नॉर्मल थ्रस्ट अंडर द लोड। कैलकुलेट मैक्सिमम पॉजिटिव एंड मैक्सिमम नेगेटिव बेंडिंग मूवमेंट। नाउ फर्स्ट फॉर द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ रिएक्शन एट सपोर्ट वी नीड टू यूज द इक्विलिब्रियम कंडीशन, दैट इज द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ रिएक्शन एट सपोर्ट। नाउ एट बोथ द सपोर्ट द रिएक्शन विल बी रिटन एज VA इन वर्टिकल डायरेक्शन, HA इन हॉरिजॉन्टल डायरेक्शन, सिमिलरली VB एंड HB। Now we will use the first equilibrium condition, that is summation of all the forces in the vertical direction is equals to zero, therefore VA plus VB is equals to 12. Now we will use the second equilibrium condition, that is moment about A is equals to zero, so it will be equals to minus VB into 30 plus 12 into 10 is equals to zero, so VB will be equals to 4 kilonewton and VA will be equals to, on putting this value in equation first, we will get VA as 8 kilonewton. Now we will use the third equilibrium condition, that is summation of all the forces in the horizontal direction is equals to 0. So HA minus HB is equals to 0 and we will get HA is equals to HB. That is the second equation. Now in two hinge arch, there will be no hinge at the crown. So we don't have the fourth equilibrium condition, so we need to find this horizontal reaction. So we will assume this HA equals to HB is equals to H as the redundant force. Now we can compute this H directly by the equation. H is equals to integration mu y dx upon integration y square dx. Now we all know that the equation of parabola is y is equals to 4rx upon l square into l minus x. On putting the value of r as 5 meter and l as 30 meter, 30 minus x, we will get the value of y as x upon 45 into 30 minus x. That is the value of y here. Now for the calculation of mu value, that is the beam moment, we had made the diagram like this. Okay. Now for AC portion, the value of beam moment will be equals to 8 into x, because of this 8 kN force, the moment will be equals to 8 into x. Similarly, for CB portion, the value of mu will be equals to 4 into 30 minus x, because of this 4 kN reaction, the moment will be equals to 4 into 30 minus x. Now we can compute the value of integration 0 to 30 mu y tx, which will be equals to integration 0 to 10 8xy dx plus 10 to 30 4 into 30 minus x into y into dx. Now on solving this, we will get this value as 44,000 divided by 9. Similarly, we can solve the value of integration 0 to 30 y square dx, and it will be equals to 0 to 30 x square into 30 minus x whole square upon 45 square into dx. We will get this value as 1 by 45 square integration 0 to 30 900 x square plus x to the power 4 minus 60 x cube into dx. On solving this, we will get 1 by 45 square in bracket 300 x cube plus x to the power 5 by 5 minus 15x to the power 4, and the lower limit is 0 and the upper limit is 30. On putting all this value, we will get integration 0 to 30 y square dx will be equals to 400. Now we can easily compute the value of h as integration 0 to 30 mu y dx upon integration 0 to 30 y square dx. Now we will put the values of both the equation here as 44,000 divided by 9 upon 400. We will get the value of h as 12.22 kilonewton. So we had computed the value of h as 12.22 kilonewton. Now we can calculate the reaction at A, that is the resultant reaction at A. So it will be equals to Ra will be equals to under root of Va square plus Ha square. On putting the value of Va and Ha here, we will get 8 square plus 12.22 square. It will be equals to 14.61 kilonewton. That will be the value of resultant reaction at A. Now we can compute its inclination with the horizontal, that is tan theta A. It will be equals to Va upon Ha. On putting the value of Va as 8 and Ha as 12.22, we can compute the value of theta as 33 degree 14 minutes. Now reaction at B can be easily computed by using the formula Rb is equals to under root of Vb square plus Hb square. On putting the value of Vb and Hb here, that is 4 square plus 12.22 square, we will get the value of Rb as 12.85 kilonewton. That will be the value of Rb. Now we want to compute its inclination with the horizontal, that is tan theta b. It will be the ratio of Vb upon Hb. On putting the value of Vb as 4 and Hb as 12.22, we will get theta b as 18 degree 6 minutes. Now we can easily compute the bending moment, radial shear and normal thrust at 10 meter from the left hinge, that is below the 12 kilonewton load. For this, we need to calculate y and slope theta at 10 meter from A support. Okay, so y will be equals to x upon 45 into 30 minus x. At x equals to 10 meter, we can get the value of y by putting the x in the above equation. Y will be equals to 4.44 meter. Now we will differentiate this equation with respect to x and we will get 30 upon 45 minus 2x upon 45. On putting the value of x equals to 10 meter in this equation, we will get tan theta is equals to dy by dx is equals to 30 upon 45 minus 2 into 10 upon 45, and theta will be equals to 12 degree 31 minutes. That will be the slope, that is 12 degree 31 minutes. Now we can easily compute the bending moment at 10 meter from A. Okay students, so bending moment at 10 meter from A will be equals to 8 into 10 because of this reaction minus 12.22 into 4.44 because of this horizontal reaction. So its value will be equals to 25.69 kilonewton meter. That will be the bending moment under the load. It will be equals to 25.69 kilonewton meter. Now to calculate the radial shear and normal thrust, we had made this section like this. Now to balance this 8 kilonewton reaction, we have to make a 8 kilonewton reaction at this point in the downward direction, as well as to balance this 12.22 kilonewton load or reaction, we need to create a 12.22 kilonewton load in the horizontal direction. The reaction that will be acting normal to the surface is known as normal thrust, that is capital N, and the reaction that will be acting radially to the surface is known as radial shear, that is represented by R. Now we had taken the normal thrust as x-axis and radial shear as y-axis. So the inclination of 8 kN load is 12 degree 31 minute from the radial shear, and the inclination of 12.22 kN load is 12 degree 31 minute from the normal thrust. Now to find the value of normal thrust and radial shear, we want to use the equilibrium condition, that is summation of all the forces in the horizontal direction is equals to 0. So the equation will be equals to n minus 12.22 cos 12 degree 31 minutes minus 8 sin 12 degree 31 minutes, and it will be equals to 13.66 kilonewton. So the value of normal thrust will be equals to 13.66 kilonewton. Now we will use the second equilibrium condition, that is summation of all the forces in the vertical direction is equals to 0, and the reaction will becomes R plus 12.22 sin 12 degree 31 minutes minus 8 cos 12 degree 31 minutes. So on solving this, we will get the value of R as 5.16 kilonewton. So we had computed the radial shear as well as normal thrust. Now the maximum bending moment. Now we need to compute the maximum bending moment. Now for finding the maximum bending moment, that is the maximum positive bending moment, it will generally lie below the loading, that is below the 12 kN load. So it will be equals to M max positive will be equals to M10, which we had already calculated as 25.69 kilonewton meter. Now for finding the maximum negative bending moment, we need to consider a section XX here whose distance is X meter from support B and its vertical ordinate is Y. So the equation will become MXX is equals to 4X due to vertical loading minus 12.22 into Y due to horizontal reaction. Now this 4X is because of this VB reaction, and this 12.22 Y is because of this reaction. On putting the value of Y as X into 30 minus X upon 45, we will get this equation like this. Now for finding the position of maximum negative bending moment, we need to differentiate this equation with respect to X and equate this value with 0, we will get the value of X. So on differentiating, we will get 4 minus 12.22 into 30 divided by 45 plus 12.22 into 2x divided by 45 is equals to 0. On solving this, we will get X is equals to 7.65 meter. That will be the position of the section XX from the support B. Now we need to compute the maximum negative bending moment. Now maximum negative bending moment will be equals to 4 into 7.65 minus 12.22 into 7.65 into 30 minus 7.65 divided by 45. We will get this value as minus 15.80 kilonewton meter. So we had solved this question completely. Thank you very much, students.